Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome all of you to our Ramadan series. Today we will be talking about Surah 101, which is Surah Al-Qari'ah. This is an 11-verse surah that was revealed in Makkah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ Al-Qari'ah. مَا الْقَارِعَةِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْقَارِعَةِ. We see this term qari'ah mentioned no less than 3 times at the beginning of this surah. What does al-qari'ah mean? Translations will say the striking calamity or the striker. Now, the word qari'ah denotes a deafening sound. It denotes a sound that is coming as a result of very loud, constant hammering of something, like the pounding of something. That is what qara'ah means. So al-qari'ah, which means the deafening sound. Now, what is the allusion here? It's alluding to none other than the event that is going to come upon everyone, and that is the Day of Judgment. And yes, some of us, of course, who have studied more, they know that Judgment Day will come upon the worst of all creation. Yes, but when I say Judgment Day will come upon all of us, I'm referring to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said that when a person dies, his or her Judgment Day has begun. So, subhanallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from this. So, this qara'ah is talking about the actual Day of Judgment and this deafening sound that will come. Now, what is interesting to note is when you hear a blast, maybe at a construction site or a sound that you're not expecting, what happens? Immediately fear is struck in the heart, right? Because you're wondering, where is this sound coming from? What's going on? Are we safe? It's almost like you go into a fight or flight mode, correct? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Al-Qari'ah, Mal-Qari'ah, the deafening, hammering, pounding sound, the blast. Mal-Qari'ah, what is this sound? Wama adaraka mal-Qari'ah, and what will possibly make you understand, appreciate, realize the extent of this striking calamity? Now, in the Quran, questions come about very frequently, and the purpose of question is sometimes to bring our attention to a concept, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer that question. Okay, so Allah will pose a question and then give us the answer. And then there are occasions when a question is given and no answer is provided. And you know what's the purpose there? To cause us to think, to cause us to fill in the blanks, to cause us to imagine and ask ourselves, what is this? What is this huge sound that will happen? And that's the purpose that we see here. Al-Qari'ah, Mal-Qari'ah, the striker, the Qari'ah, the striking calamity. What is the striking calamity? And what will possibly give you any inkling, clue, idea of what the striking calamity is? وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَالْقَارِعَةِ يَوْمَ يَكُونُ النَّاسُ كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَبْثُوثِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he gives us some information here, it is the day on which the human beings, or all of humanity, shall be like scattered moths. كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَبْثُوثِ, like scattered moths. Now think about this. Of course, now it's the COVID-19 pandemic and we are not able to congregate, but you've seen what happens when in a small area, there are a lot of people. It could even be out in the open at a park or elsewhere. It's just so busy, right? Now imagine when all of humanity, right from the time of Adam alayhi salam until Judgment Day, all of those people. Can you just imagine the number? What's the global population right now? Over 7 billion, right? Or close to around 7 billion. Now imagine all of humanity from then until now. And by the way, human beings, the global population is on an exponential growth trajectory. Just the other day, it was interesting to see that they're saying it took human beings 200 million years to get to the first billion. And then from 1 billion to the second billion hardly took 2 generations or so. Something interesting like that. Don't quote me on this. Do your own research. But very interesting statistic here. So what are we seeing? What's going to happen when you have all of humanity from the time of Adam alayhi salam until Judgment Day? Where will people be crammed up? So it makes sense. Like scattered moths. And any one of you who's gone camping or been outside during the monsoon season or during the summer, or when you have these lights turn on, what happens? It attracts all kinds of insects, right? There's an authentic hadith, the Prophet, peace be upon him, says, beautiful hadith, he says that my example and your example is like a man who has kindled, lit up a fire at night. And all these creatures, all these insects are being attracted to this source of light and jumping into it, not realizing it's a fire that will kill them, they'll burn them alive. And I am like that person. And you are like, I'm like that person who's lit up the fire, and you are like these people, those insects that are insisting on jumping into this light, thinking that it's light, but no, it is the fire. And I'm holding you from your waist. I'm holding on to you, but you're slipping away from me. And you feel that sense of desperation in the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that I'm doing everything to hold you back, that don't destroy yourselves. Don't get into the fire. That the Rasul, peace be upon him, has given us a way to live, his authentic ahadith, his sunnah, the manual of life, the Quran, that we should read, that we should live our lives by. But no, human beings are insisting in jumping into the fire. May Allah protect us. So, كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَبَثُوثِ وَتَكُونُ الْجِبَالُ كَالْعِهْنِ الْمَنْفُوشِ. And the mountains shall be like wool that is fluffed up. Some translations will tell you like carded wool. Now imagine if the mountains will turn into that. What will be the issue? What will be the situation with us human beings? What will be that day? SubhanAllah, we can't even fathom. وَتَكُونُ الْجِبَالُ كَالْعِهْنِ الْمَنْفُوشِ فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. This is the point, the heart, the essence of this magnificent surah. فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ. Those whose scales shall be heavy. Now Allah hasn't told us heavy with what. Again, it's understood. فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. Their عِيشَة, their life shall be the most radiant, the most brilliant. They'll be in a life of pleasure. May Allah make you and me from them. Allahumma ameen. What are these scales? We don't know the reality of these scales, but there will be some weighting that will be going on. And it's in the plural. It's not wazan, it's mawazin. So the scholars have explained that maybe each person will have their own individual scales because it's a plural. Or it's just one scale, but the reality of it, will it have multiple mini scales? We don't know anything about this scale, but it will be weighed. Some scholars say an individual himself or herself will be weighed. Some say no, the deeds will be weighed. We don't know. So Allah is saying, when good deeds shall be heavy, this person will have a beautiful life. وَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ. While for the one whose, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ, the one whose deeds are light. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about, you know, heavy deeds, and then he talks about light deeds. So when a person's deeds are lightweight, then فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ, this person, their residence shall be a scorching, will be an abyss. هَاوِيَةٌ. Now it's interesting here, Allah uses the word What does mean? Means mother. Why mother? It's refuge, right? For a child, when they're in trouble, what's the first place of refuge? It's the mom. So it's very interesting. Allah says, فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ. It's sarcasm in the Quran that a place of refuge, how can a fire be a place of refuge? Now that's the worst place of refuge. So some people misunderstand this, that it means their mother will be the fire. No, what Allah is saying is where their home will be the fire. May Allah protect you and I from that. Allahumma ameen. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ. What will make you understand what this is? نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ. It is a scorching fire. Now, all fires are hot and scorching, right? But Allah mentions the scorching nature of this fire to prove a point, to emphasize that this is a most deadly type of fire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from this. It's Ramadan. Make lots and lots of dua. We're towards the end of Ramadan. The last 10 nights will soon be upon us. Make lots of dua to Allah to protect us from Jahannam, to enter us into Jannah, and to fill our scales and make them heavy with good deeds. Allahumma ameen. If you benefited from this reminder, make sure that you hit the subscribe button. If you're watching this on YouTube, follow me on Instagram and Facebook. All of the handles of my social media are given in the description of this video, alongside the various programs I'm doing in English and Urdu and my Jumu'ah khutbas. Share it far and wide, and you get the reward as well. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.